Hello and good evening to everyone. This is Ritesh Suman from second year Computer Science Department of BBPIMT. Along with me, here are my friends Rajushi Bishwas, Pratyush, and Rahul. We all will be presenting the topic definition of Turing machine. As we all know that this is a very important topic in the subject of automata, and everyone is very what can I say, that it's a very good topic. It's a very interesting topic, and as deep we go, we will discover a lot of thing about it. And very interesting fact about this is that till date, like we are in 2020, from 1936 when it was invented from Alan Turing in 1936 till date, it is the powerful machine and the computation machine which is ever made. Even today's machine cannot compete with it. Let me proceed in my presentation. So here is the introduction part. At first, it was introduced in 1936. It's a very simple mathematical model of computer. And what can you say that it is a benchmark of computation. What can you say mean by benchmarks? That if some problem is being solved by Turing machine, then it can be solved by other machines. If it cannot be solved by Turing machine, none of the computer or none of the system can solve it. So this is the main thing behind it. It's the most powerful machine ever made. Here is something. Turing machine is a finite state machine and it has an infinite if. And the main logic behind this is it consists of an infinite if. It's a it goes to the infinity from the both end. Like I will give the example. Here's my here's the picture. Now we can see that this is our infinite if, and this is a two-way step. This tends to positive infinity and this tends to negative infinity. And here is the control head. It control which it can write and it can read also. Like in PDA, we have only read, but here we can read and as well as write. Coming to the first presentation. It normally accepts the input string and complete its computation over it, and entering a final and accepting this. And basically, what the actual functioning of this tape is, this tape is used for inputting and as well as for storage. Like in the previous, we have also learned about the PDA. There we use a stack for our memory. But here, all the memory and the things which are doing, which we use to for storage, all of these are stored in the tape. From now onward, Pratyush will take the lead and he will.
In this slide, we can see the rules which are followed in this tape. We can read a cell one by one, and we can also change the content of each cell. We can move either right or to the left of the tape with the help of the control. We can use as much as we want from the tape. It's like infinite storage, stored as elements as we wish. What we cannot do in this tape is that we cannot jump from one cell to more than two cells. It means that we can move from one cell to another cell one by one. A set of things is given and we can use them only as input to our machine. In this slide, as we can see from this slide, a Turing machine is represented by seven set of tuples, where Q is the finite state of states, sigma is a state of tau, not including B, where tau is the set of input symbol. Tau is finite state of allowable tape symbol. Then del. Del is the transition function defined as Q cross tau cross L or R, where L, R depend on whether we move either right or to the left of the tape. Q naught is our initial state or start state. B is a symbol of tau, that is blank symbol, that is used for filling up empty sequence in our tape. F is set of final states. So F is a set of final states. Then in next slide, we can see a model of this Turing machine. As we can see, with the help of finite control or the control, we can move to left or write of this step one by one. And the storage limit of this step is infinite, and we can see that the empty sequence in this step is filled up by B. Now the next slide will be explained by Rajoshi.
Okay, so the next slide, we denote the transition function. The transition function is like when you want to go from one state to another state, or sort of like when an input is given. So here is the transition function in which way it is given, like sigma q x denotes to p y r y l. Here q is the current state and x is the given input, where p is the next state, which will be q to p, and y is the symbol where after giving the input, x will be replaced by y, and r y l is denoting that whether the head will move to left or right. R denotes right and l denotes left. So Turing machine can work as a language acceptor. As we all know, the Turing machine works like when it goes to the final state, and it has two points. It either halt and accept, or either halt or reject. So if it halts in the final state, it can accept its input or either reject its input. So for a language accepted by M, M we define like where W is the input symbol. So W belongs to the input symbol. There is Q0W, which goes to X1, QF, which is the final state, and X2. And X1, X2, it's belongs to the tau symbol. What is the tape symbol? Let us go to the next slide. Okay, the Turing machine can work also as a transducer. What transducer mean is like we can give it, works like a function. We can give it an input. It can also gives us a it can also produce a output. So what is done when the input, we can treat the entire non-blank portion of the tape as an input. So there is like we can work it as an adder or many things like complement of A. Like this, the Q0 is the initial state and X is the input, and the final state will be QF and Y. And the what is the ID that the Turing machine will inform, like X1, X2, XI, -1, Q, this is the present state, and the rest of is like this. Either we can fill up the empty slots as many much with blank as we want. Is a sigma q xi equal to p y r. It is the same as x1, x2, x minus 1. It is the same. And that q goes to p, p is the next state, where xi is replaced by 1. Now Rahul will be described.
Okay. So in this slide, we are discussing about the various variations of the Turing machine, which are multi-tape Turing machine, non-deterministic Turing machine, multi-head Turing machines, offline Turing machines, and multi-dimensional Turing machine. And on the next slide, there are various examples of different variations of the Turing machines. Next. These are the examples of various variations of the Turing machine. Next. Now we come to the applications of the Turing machine, which are check decidability. If Turing machine cannot solve a problem in a countable time, then there could not be any algorithm which could solve that problem. That is, the problem is undecidable. For a decision problem, if its Turing machine halts in countable time for all the finite inputs, then we can say that the problem could be solved by the algorithm in countable time. classify, second one is the classify the problems. Turing machine helps to classify decidable problems into classes of polynomial hierarchy. Suppose we found that the problem is decidable, then our target become how efficiently we can solve it. The efficiency being calculated in number of steps, extra space used, length of the code / side of the finite state machine. And the third application is design and implement algorithm for practical machine, in which Turing machine helps to propagate idea of algorithm in other practical machines. After the successful check of one or two criteria, we can use our practical devices or computers to design and implement the algorithm. Next.
So again, now coming to some of the questions, and we'll discuss some of the questions. And here, the first question there. Let M be the encoding of Turing machine as a string over sigma is equal to 0 and 1. So these are our inputs, 0 and 1, where L is M, and M is a Turing machine that accepts a string of length 2014. Then L is, this is the MCQ type question. And basically, these are the questions which are asked in gate examination. So here, there are four options. First, decidable and recursively enumerable. And the second option is this, undecidable but recursively enumerable. The third option is undecidable and not recursively enumerable. The fourth option is decidable but recursively enumerable. So the correct option is B, undecidable but recursively enumerable. So the expression here is that here is the fundamental of halting in Turing machine. So the main fundamental behind it is this: if input string is present in the language, then Turing machine will halt at the final stage. But if machine is unable to accept the input string, then it will halt on the non-final step, and that goes for an infinite loop, and it will never give a halt. Thus, we can say that L here is undecidable and recursively enumerable. I hope everything is right. Here the second question, very simple question. And between three statements, we have to select which of the statements are true. So here, the first option is the complement of every Turing decidable language is Turing decidable. Absolutely, the complement of every Turing decidable language is Turing decidable. Absolutely true. And the second one is this: there exists some language which is in NP but is not Turing decidable. No, it's not. And the last one is, if L is language in NP and L is Turing decidable, yeah, it is also absolutely correct. So the option goes, option number 4, 1 and 3 are the correct. The next question is that, which of the following are method model equivalent to Turing machine? So before starting this question, I would like to say that there are many methods to create a Turing machine. Like we can use one more stack in PDA to create a Turing machine. So here are many options. The first option is multi-tape Turing machine. Yes, we have already have a view over it in the previous slides. Second option is multi-track Turing machine. Yes, and the register machine. Yeah, this is also a part of Turing machine. So the correct option will be all of the mentioned. Coming to next question, which of the following are decidable? So the option are whether the intersection of two regular languages infinite. Yes, we can decide from Turing machine. Whether the given context-free language is regular, we cannot do it from the Turing machine. Whether two pushdown automata accept the same language, yes, we cannot decide it from Turing machine. Whether a given grammar is context-free, yeah, definitely we can check from it from Turing machine. So the option here, 1 and 4 are correct. So option will be second. 1 and 4 are correct. Yes. So all these are four are MCQ type question. And here come here there is a question. We have to construct a Turing machine from language L, where we can have two strings. One is the actual string, and the another substring will be the reverse of the previous string, and the input will be 0 and 1. So there, what we can approach, how can we approach to solve this question is that simply, as we know that we have only two inputs, 0 and 1. So what we can do that, just for identifying the variables, we can use x and y instead of 0 and 1. So we will using y in place of 0 and x in place of 1. So what our approach is that, so basic, in spite of all this thing, what we will do in daily life, if we have to check whether a string is a reverse of another string or not, what we can, we will just match every digit, every alphabet of that string with the another string from the last. If both are matching, then we will say yes, definitely it's the reverse of this. So this is the basic logic behind it, and we will be implementing that logic in the question. So as we have already told, we will be replacing 0 with y and 1 with x. So first is that, if symbol is 0, replace it by y and go to step q. It will be very complex if I will go from this step. It will be very easy if I will be defining this one. So here is our q0, that is the starting state, and this arrow represents the starting node or initial node. From this state, we will go to this. If this is 1, as we have already in the previous slide, we already know how to do the transition. So if 1 is there, we will replace 1 by x and we will move to right. So this action will be, if 1 is encountered, then we will be replacing 1 from x and we will move a right side. So we will run this loop infinitely, not infinitely, but until and unless we reach the last. So 00R and 11R. So if y in the last, if y is encountered, then we will move from, if that is encountered, then we will move. And the 0, if 0, then replacing by y and moving towards the right side. Again, same thing until and unless we reach the last one, and the same logic. And after that, we will, there is a loop, and we will, after encountering that, we will move to left, coming to the previous state, and again. So if the whole this thing is checked, then we will come to this part, and now we will check, and if everything is fine, we will declare this yes, it is true. So this is all about presentation about Turing machine. Hope everyone understand, and thank you everyone.
Yes, very good presentation. But one or two thing is that I think that you should in the MCQ you started with the hardest example first, so that is one. You should take it first example should be the last example, otherwise excellent presentation. And whenever you are taking a Turing machine definition, it is better to take some textbooks like Michael Sipser or Kohobi, and you take the picture out of it and mention, because in certain books, Michael Sipser books, it is a 6 tuple, and certain books are 7 tuples. So you should know this, there sometimes the blank alphabets is scared, so I think you should know both. And very
yes,
good. Sir. Yeah, certain books. It is even in Pushdown Automata also. You see, certain books says 6 tuple and certain books say 7. Both are correct. And another, I found that Turing halting problem. You should decide. That is a very interesting problem. And in the yes, case sir. Of in the case of WWR, it can be solved by non-deterministic PDE also. But WW problem can be done only Turing machine. So, as a interesting problem, WW is the most interesting problem in Turing machine, because WW.
Yes, WW and WCW.
Yeah, yes, WW and WCW. Yes, you are absolutely correct. That can be done only Turing machine. But WWR, it is generally done by Turing machine, but it can be solved by yes. non-deterministic PDA. But very good. You have done a very good presentation. Next time, I am expecting you a good presentation. With actual this thing, and okay, thank you very much. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Okay.